ఇండియా ఆఫ్థాల్మాలజికల్ సొసైటీ, కేరళ సొసైటీ ఆఫ్ అఫ్థామిక్ సర్జన్స్, అఫ్థామిక్ సొసైటీ ఆఫ్ కండూర్, కాంప్ట్రస్ చారిటబుల్ ట్రస్ట్ ఐ హాస్పిటల్ తలశ్ശേരി എന്നിവർ സംയുക്തമായി സെപ്റ്റംബർ 1-ാം തീയതി ഞായറാഴ്ച കണ്ണൂർ ഇ.കെ. നായനർ അക്കാദമി ഹാളിൽ വെച്ച് നേത്രചികിത്സയിലുള്ള ആധുനിക മുന്നേറ്റങ്ങളെക്കുറിച്ചുള്ള ഒരു നാഷണൽ സിമ്പോസിയം സംഘടിപ്പിക്കുന്നുണ്ട്. സംഘടിപ്പിച്ചു നാഷണൽ സിമ്പോസിയം സംഘടിപ്പിച്ചു. ഇതിൽ ഇന്ത്യയിലെ വിവിധ ഭാഗത്തു നിന്നുള്ള നേത്രചികിത്സയിലെ സബ് സ്പെഷ്യാലിറ്റീസ് ഉള്ള വിദഗ്ധർ സംസാരിച്ചു. കേരളത്തിൻ്റെ വിവിധ ഭാഗത്തു നിന്നും നേത്രരോഗ വിദഗ്ധർ ഇതിൽ പങ്കെടുപ്പിച്ചു.
സച്ചിദാനന്ദ രൂപമേ സസ്നേഹ കേദാരമേ സത്തായ മാർഗം ത്യജിച്ചിടുക സത്യ സ്വരൂപ വിഭോ നീ സത്യ സ്വരൂപ വിഭോ. Namrata Sharma, who is the General Secretary, Honorary General Secretary of the All India Ophthalmological Society, as our chief guest today. She had visited Kannur, as she said, during Drishti 2018, and I think the fact that she has come again shows that she is very happy and impressed with Kannur and its ophthalmologists. So we are very happy to have you again, Dr. Namrata, and thank you for coming here on our invite, and we hope that you will come here again and again. I welcome Dr. Namrata Sharma this event. Even though I called Srini so many times, please call me for something, call me if you need, he never called me, he never disturbed me. And I should say that behind him is a very well-oiled machinery, especially a very pretty girls and doctors. That is the keynote address here. Okay, so he has got a lot of people who is backing him, and he has got a very, very good support system in Compress Eye Hospital and Compress Eye Trust, the trust behind him and his management. And I welcome, though he is not here, I welcome the president of the trust and also the all the trustees. I also welcome vice joint secretary of IMA, Talisheri, Dr. Arvind Nambiar. He is also a participant in the organizing of this. Dr. Srini, he doesn't need any introduction, but let me tell you that he is one of the most energetic, meticulous, and he doesn't delegate things. I think he doesn't delegate things to us, but he delegates to other people. That is a secret. Very good. And Dr. Thomas Cherian. And they are Dr. J.K. Reddy, Coimbatore, Dr. Santosh Manavar, and Dr. Saravanan, and Dr. Anuradha here. They are here from the beginning. and Dr. Fairuz is just coming, and Dr. Satyan is here, and Dr. Prashant. Thank you all once again. I welcome all the delegates who are here today. I'm sure you will be having a very fruitful session today. Have a very energetic day, taking back with you lots of new knowledge, new expertise and new memories, which will help you in your daily life and your daily practice. Thank you all once again, and we welcome you heartily once again. Thank you, and enjoy your day.
First of all, I would like to thank Annamalai Madam for permitting us to conduct this conference under the aegis of All India Ophthalmological Society. This is the 25th CME being held under the aegis of Kerala Society of Ophthalmic Surgeons, and possibly to be the highest number of CMEs being conducted by any state society. KSOS also has progressed from being just primarily an academic organization to a wholesome organization over the last 2 years. We have recently been granted 12A status by the Income Tax Department 2 years back, 2 days back, which is a great achievement. We have been trying to get it for a long time, but finally we have got it. But one of the major reasons why we got this is that over the past few years, we have been doing a lot of social service activities. One of the major activity which that we did last year was a flood relief activity during last year's flood. For that also, I should thank Dr. Namrata. Once I got permission from Dr. Radha Ramanan to collect funds for the flood relief, the first person that I called was Dr. Namrata. I told her we're going to collect, and she just asked me, how much have you planned to collect? No idea, we had not planned at all. I just said 50 lakhs, madam. See, that became our target. And we could achieve it, and even more. And we donated more than 50 lakhs to the CMDRF. Along with that, we have done a lot of direct relief activities in different parts of the state. And so there are many other activities which my president, Dr. Shashi Kumar, would be explaining. AAOS, Dr. Namrata, gave ₹5 lakhs to the CMDRF from the AAOS fund. Thank you for that also, madam. See, ophthalmology, see, what we wanted to do something big in Kannur. So that's the why we thought of doing a national symposium on advances in ophthalmology. So definitely ophthalmology is one of the medical specialties that has achieved tremendous advancements in the recent years. We are the best specialists from different parts of India to share their vast experience with us during this day. There are a lot of game-changing researches going on in ophthalmology. I've heard the talk of Dr. David Smadja from Israel during the last ASCRS. They're doing this Israeli researchers are doing have actually come out with eye drops that we call nanodrops, which will change the refractive status of the eye. And this drops, which is being produced by nanotechnology, can correct refractive errors and take away the need of using glasses. So it's going into human trials in 2020. Another research that we've come across is that on a new molecule, Protondin, which has shown great promise in regeneration of optic nerve fibers, and if it really works, it's going to be a real boon to those who are blind by optic neuropathy because of glaucoma and all. See, our own dear Dr. Santosh Shanavar, has developed brachytherapy technique with bark. So that is going to be a game changer in the ocular oncology field in India. So there will be a lot more that will be discussed by the best in India today. Along with this, we will be having a training program, KSO's residence training program for nurses and paramedics today. It starts in the afternoon in Hall B. This is regarding the conference and generally about a little bit about KSO's. I now request Professor Dr. Namrata Sharma to kindly deliver the inaugural address and inauguration.
To come back to Kerala, and this is second time in Kannur. It's a good connect. Like Srini said, that when the flood relief victims had to be helped, I think it was very clear. And he said that if you give anything, it goes to the Chief Minister's Relief Fund, and I want to help the ophthalmologists. And that is why I want to collect the money. So he was very clear in his thought process, and then I asked him how much, and he said, I don't know. He said, but then you have to have a figure. And then he said, okay, 50 lakhs. So it just came out like that. So I said, okay, let's start with a token grant, and I'm thankful to the governing council of AIOS who immediately agreed on the same. There are a lot of things, I think, as a society, which Kerala is already doing. It's doing so many activities, whether you see the CME programs, and I'm told that at the district level it is very active in the CME programs for the district ophthalmologists, and that is something I think which we all need to focus on, which doesn't happen, because generally what happens is that the CME programs are held more in the metropolitan cities and not in the interiors, where they are actually required for upgrading the knowledge. So that is, I think, something which is very good, and also the social service activities, because I think we do, all said and done, the doctors and the ophthalmologists do need to show a very good image of themselves, because as it is, we do a lot of charitable activities, but then the public should know about it, and when you do these social activities, then the public really comes to know about it. So both at the state level and at the AIOS level also, I think the R of today is advocacy. We need to project ourselves, portray ourselves, and help each other. Whether it was the PCPNDT Act for the ultrasound machines, which the AIOS took an initiative on and got a PIL so that our ophthalmologists are not unnecessarily harassed, or whether it was PIL against the TPS, who are again harassing for the payments. The initiative came from our own members from the various state societies, like Pune, like Maharashtra Ophthalmological Society, like Rajasthan Ophthalmological Society, and we just took it up and it happened. So I think advocacy is really required. And then whether it was opposing the NMC bill, or whether it was condemning an act of violence against the doctors, it is important that we voice our opinion against this, and it is also important that we portray ourselves in good light. in front of the public. So these two things I think are important. AIOS is of course working for the fellow ophthalmologists also, like in terms of ophthalmology, like we do always, like we are holding the surgeon hours to show you the live surgical videos, so that you know you can see, you can peep into the operation theater of the luminaries and of the institutions which you would like to go, but then you don't have to waste time in traveling, in you know, getting your logistics on. So you can just watch those live surgical demonstrations from wherever you are, on your laptop or on your mobile. Then apart from this, I think very soon we are also coming up with travel fellowships for our young ophthalmologists, so that you know they can, when they are attending European congresses or American congresses, the travel fellowships are going to be funded by the AIOS, depending upon of course on the merit. Then the journals are going to be, from the next week onwards, I think we have about 6 to 10 journals which will which you will be able to access, the full text of which you will be able to access on your laptops without having to pay for it. And this is going to be starting from next week onwards. Then apart from that, we are already in the process of making an ophthalmic museum now, and again within by September end there will be an ophthalmic museum at the headquarters, where we housed several of the antique pieces which our older ophthalmologists, senior ophthalmologists like Dr. P. N. Nagpal have donated. So if you visit Delhi and if you come to AIOS headquarters, that will be again one place to look at. Then apart from that, we are also making a state-of-the-art wet lab at the AIOS headquarters itself, so that if somebody wants to do surgeries, practice surgeries, and there are no wet labs available, then you can do your, you know, practice your surgeries there also. And as soon as that happens, then we will come to the zones. So it will be a south zone wet lab, north zone wet lab, and east zone, west zone wet lab, like that, so that you again don't have to travel to Delhi for those wet labs, and you have in your own regional area. So these are some of the things that we are going to start. And apart from this, again, congratulations to all of you for this national symposium. Again, it was Srini's idea, and he says, I want to call it national symposium for recent advances in ophthalmology. So he just gives you an idea, and then you know, you don't know what to say, but to accept it and to make it happen, depending upon whatever your power is or your control is. So, but I think we must congratulate the entire Ophthalmic Society at Kannur for taking this forward, and I'm sure it's going to be a very good CME from where a lot of points will be taken.
The PG training program this year, under the leadership of our scientific committee chairman Dr. Gopal, we had what we wanted to do was, we concentrated on the first year postgraduates, because ophthalmology mostly is it's not by choice, it is by chance. Most of the people take up ophthalmology by chance, very few by choice. So what happens is that they are at a loss when they come to the ophthalmology department. They don't know how to handle the slit lamp, they don't know how to handle the indirect. So we concentrated on those techniques. We wanted to teach the young postgraduates how to examine an ophthalmic case. And in addition to that, we concentrated on the soft skills, how to communicate with the patient, how to reveal a bad news to the patient, how to handle a hostile patient and a bystander. All those aspects were taught. We had two programs, very successful programs, in Calicut and Trivandrum. And the one program, the last program for the central zone, will be held next week in LF Hospital, Angamali. That was what we have intended for the postgraduate, and now we are having a PG gold medal exam coming in September. That will be for the postgraduates. And our journal, under the able editorship of our editor Bastin, we are in the process of indexation of our journal. We are bringing out a book on diabetes. One CME update for the doctors, and one book for the in vernacular for the public. That also will be released during this year. And unfortunately, like last year, this year also we had damages due to the flood, mostly in the North Kerala region. It is not the flood that caused the damage, it was the landslides that caused the damage. And so we had to intervene. We supplied materials there, and now we are planning to construct a bridge in one of the remote tribal villages in Nilambur that also the KSOS will be taking up. And our flagship project of low vision project for Kerala. We had taken up this project last year, and this year we had inaugurated that project. We trained our paramedics or the optometrists from three centers, selected centers in three zones of Kerala. We have got them trained at Aravind Eye Hospital, Madurai, and we have started the low vision project. We have named it Vision Enhancement Project, because it is not only low vision that we have to handle, we have to enhance the vision of patients. So it has been christened Vision Enhancement Project, and we have already started that. And we are having a crisis management cell under the KSOS, where unfortunately if somebody lands up with an endophthalmitis, either an isolated or a cluster endoph, we have got a group of experts in our KSOS who can help them tackle those situations. And now, I mean, to sum up, 9 months back in the same city, we had enrolled into a board exam, and I can say that my team has performed very well. And in 3 months, we will be evaluated by people like you. I hope we will come out.
I'd like to congratulate and wish them all the best to the organizers, the organizing committee, led by Dr. Srini and his team. Thank you.
Nevertheless, it was a pleasant surprise when Srini invited me. And today I find a constellation of superstars in Indian ophthalmology descending to this glorious venue of Ikenayanar Hall. And I'm sure all of us will go back enriched with our knowledge in ophthalmology, and we'll be going back with a heavy baggage. I wish the CME all success.
It's a great pleasure to stand before you to propose vote of thanks, because it is the national symposium that we are conducting here. It's a very rare occasion in Kannur. First of all, I would like to extend my deep gratitude to Dr. Namrata Sharma, chief guest of the day. She has delivered the speech also, and thank you, madam, from taking this off. Next, I extend my gratitude to Shashi, Dr. Shashi. Shashi is my classmate. That's why I thought Shashi. And you know how he became my classmate. I'm not explaining from here. And one more classmate is here, Thomas Surya. So I extend both of you, KSOS persons, to come here and enlighten us. And Dr. Mary, she's my friend. And thank you, Mary, for doing all the help and also the attending the after function. And Dr. Aravind Nambiar is my, he's a singer. Most of you may not be knowing that. And I know him personally because he's a singer. And he is Joint Secretary of IMA, Thalassery. Thalamay Thalassery is the most vibrant branch. Thank you, Aravind, to come out here. And next is our Srini, who presided at the function. I don't think he needs any gratitude extension, but yeah, all of you have seen that he is walking, and he has a metatarsal fracture for the last 1 week, but he never bothered, even he had taken a day leave, and he is doing all the surgeries as usual, and no change in the schedule also. So such a vibrant secretary we got, and such a vibrant surgeon we got our hospital. Thank you, Srini, for everything. And next I extend my gratitude to my colleagues and who are the MCs, Dr. Soumya and Dr. Jasina and all the other colleagues. And all, next is our delegates. I extend my gratitude to all the delegates, seniors and also my colleagues to come over in large numbers and come over here. And the next is our audiovisual aids and the academy and authorities of the Nayanar Academy. I extend my gratitude to all them also. And my contest staff, they are very, very important mention, because for the last so many days, so many weeks, they will be helping us to arrange this function during day and also during night. I extend the gratitude to them also.